Jay from Milwaukee asked this question.
Hi, Todd. I have a data set where I measured people's performance on the same task 3 times. I want to use their best score out of the 3. How can I do that in SPSS?
Thank you, Jay. That's an excellent question. This is something that I have seen multiple times in various research projects. So, for example, a teacher allows students to redo a quiz multiple times and then keeps only the highest score. A medical researcher gave hip replacement patients 3 opportunities to complete a fall risk test and then used only the highest score of the 3. A sports medicine researcher has athletes do a strength test and then takes the best score out of 4 attempts. Now the problem is that the best score may be the first score for some people, the second score for others, the 3rd score for others, so you simply cannot use score number 3 for all of your participants. What you want SPSS to do is look through those 3 scores and then return only the highest score. Now you can do this with any variables of the same kind. So for instance, time measured in seconds, or scores on a scale of 1 to 10. But you must have at least 2 variables for SPSS to compare. So Jay, the function that you want to use is called max. And let me show you how to do that in SPSS. Go to transform, compute variable. We will call our new variable best, because this is the best score for each person on their 3 measurements. In this case, the best score is the highest score. For the numeric expression, you type the function max, followed by parentheses. Within the parentheses, you would place all of the variables that you want to compare, separated by commas. Click OK. The new variable is the best score out of the 3. If you wanted the lowest score, or the fastest time, or the lowest price, or just simply the smallest value, you would do something very similar using the min function. Go to transform, compute variable. We will call our new variable worst, although you could call it fastest or lowest. Type the function min, followed by parentheses. Within the parentheses, you would place all of the variables that you want to compare, separated by commas. Click OK. Now notice that for both max and min functions, SPSS ignores the missing values. So if you are looking for the lowest of 3 scores, but one participant only has 2 scores, SPSS will ignore the missing value and return the lowest valid score. Now, if it is important that a participant complete a minimum number of items in order to be included in your data set, such as they have to complete at least 3 out of 5 items in order to have their high score calculated, you can do that by adding a .3 behind the max or the min function. Participants with only 1 or 2 scores out of 5 would be excluded. Only those who have 3 or more scores will be included in your data set. You can do this same trick with other functions, such as the mean. This way, a participant has to complete a certain number of items to be included with your data. You can use the min and max functions with string variables as well. So if grades have been recorded as letters, A, B, C, D, F, the min function would return the first letter, which would be an A in this case, and the max function would return the furthest letter in the alphabet, which in this case would be an F. To do this in SPSS, go to transform, compute variable. We will call our new variable top, as in top score. Create the formula as you did previously. The top score is the first letter, or an A, so we would use the min function followed by parentheses. Within the parentheses, you would add all of the string variables that you want to compare. For this to work with string variables and not throw an error, you must click on Type and Label. And then you can set the type to string. Click Continue and OK. This column is the top letter grade for each of the quizzes. Now note that you cannot do this with scores like A, A+, A-, because SPSS will return the A as the high score, followed by A+, and then A-. And to help you along, I've also included the syntax for these examples in the video description below. So Jay, thank you for asking that question, and I hope that your research project goes well. And for all of you, thank you for watching.